वेलकम टू दिस लेक्चर ऑन प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस एंड प्रोसेसिंग. व्हाट वी गोना कवर इज एलोंगेशन, एलोंगेशन फैक्टर्स, पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन एलोंगेशन. फर्स्ट वी विल सी व्हाट इज एलोंगेशन. एलोंगेशन इज अ साइक्लिक प्रोसेस इन विच वन अमाइनो एसिड एडेड एट अ टाइम. द सीक्वेंस ऑफ पॉलीपेप्टाइड will be determined by the codon carried by mRNA. The elongation rate in E. coli is 15 amino acid per second. Next, there are three stages of elongation. First one is decoding. The aminoacylated tRNA whose anticodon is complementary to the codon of mRNA. Next stage is of transpeptidation. The peptidyl group present in the P site transfer to the aminoacyl group present in the A site through formation of peptide bond. CONH, this is known as peptide bond. This is how one amino acid linked to the another one. Last stage is of translocation. After addition of amino acid, A site tRNA and P site tRNA transfer to the P site and E site respectively. Next are the elongation factor which helps in elongation. First one, elongation factor TU, which is also known as elongation factor 1A. It places the tRNA to its correct position. As you can see over here, EFTU is GTP bound format. That means it is active in state. After tRNA bound to ribosome, the hydrolysis takes place, that means GTP to GDP reaction takes place, it becomes inactive. So how it gets active for the next cycle? Let's see. The EFTS, that is elongation factor TS, which is also known as elongation factor 1B, regenerates the EFTU. As you can see over here, EFTU is now activated. The process is unknown how it is activated, but this is very crucial process. Please remember this because so many questions ask from this process. Third elongation factor is very necessary, which helps in translocation, is nothing but the elongation factor G, also known as elongation factor 2.